halfway through the week, 9 days into April, and 10 minutes away from being up to speed on current events. Welcome to CNN Student News. Another thing that helped Adrian Haslett Davis, a customized bionic leg developed at MIT. It's one example of medical research helping someone recover. Another involves electrical stimulation, a potential breakthrough for people who've been paralyzed. It has its limits. It won't help people walk again, at least not yet, but it does allow for voluntary movement where previously there was none.
Dustin Shilcox is paralyzed from the chest down.
Okay, try to move your leg.
He can't move even a tiny bit.
No.
But doctors implanted this device, sending electrical stimulation to his spine. And when Dustin turns it on...
Whoa. There you go.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
He can move on demand.
Okay, right leg back.
And then forward.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
When the stimulator's turned off, Dustin can't even sit up because his torso muscles don't work. But turn it on, and Dustin can sit up without any support at all.
The first time I turned it on, it was exciting and emotional for me at the same time. Emotional because I was told that I'd never be able to walk or move my legs again.
Dustin is one of four patients in a new study published Tuesday. Despite their gains, none can walk on their own. The device works by activating one leg at a time. It's not the first time electrical stimulation has helped paralyzed patients, but experts say this technique may become an important tool in the toolbox.
Wow. I think that what's incredibly exciting is that we've opened up a realm of possibilities of what we can do now with people who are paralyzed, and we've just scratched the surface.